meditation. Letting our attention from wherever we've centered, bring it back into this body, into this place, into this time. Like we draw our attention inside, not just inside the body, but inside time, to this moment. And in this moment, we recognize our body and our kind. To be grateful. Your body may not be the best, but it's certainly not the worst. And despite sometimes treating our body with little respect, not giving it rest when it asks for some rest, pushing it sometimes into danger zones, now we can be with our body. Relax it. Be kind to it. Smile to your body so your body can smile back. In order to relax our body, it's like we need to make sure that nothing is squashed, compressed, pulled apart, stretched, strained, that nothing is out of its comfortable shape. All of the information and pictures and ideas about what is the best posture. Now you feel your body. You get to know him, get to understand him. Until you can find out the best position. Your body is full of awareness, wisdom, knowledge of what's best, much more than personal ideas or theories. So you ask your body, are you comfortable now? Is there anything I can do? Make you more comfortable. And listen for the answer. If the body asks you to adjust your legs, then please do so. How does that feel now? This is fine-tuning the comfort of the body. It's like if you have a piano before you play it, you have to tune it up. Some strings would have got loose, some got tight. And a sensitive, mindful, wise musician could easily tune the piano to its best possible pitch. You do that to your body, starting off with the legs. Just really feeling them. And even if it's not moving them, you can feel some tightness or tension somewhere. You imagine that part of the body just expanding, soothing. I'm imagining my left knee now as if it was sinking in into a satin-covered soft pillow, just so easy. And all of any remnant tightness disappearing. I'm pampering my left knee in my imagination. And it's responding by relaxing. My mindfulness picks up the feedback. It is actually getting more comfortable. But don't stop at medium level comfort. I really go for deep comfort, deep peace, physical peace. And I go up my body, never ever forgetting the neglected butt. Time of abuse, some people, I linger there. I relax. Sometimes just paying attention to somebody. Smiling at the person in the street, they feel that it makes a difference. So I'm just kind to that hard-working, neglected part of my body, my buttocks. Soothing them. Bringing them to deep comfort. So many parts, the outside, the inside, just go, oh, check thoroughly, just by doing a scan of the machine. If I see anything, just some tightness. I use some type of skillful means, imagination, whatever. Ease everything. If it's cold, I imagine warmth. If it's hot, I cool it down. Make my waist and all the bones and ligaments and parts in that area. May it be at ease. Free. Sometimes an animal in the cage gets tight, tense, upset. You free everything. Sometimes the animal doesn't want to leave. It's nice in there. But at least it hasn't got the feeling of being forced, made to be somewhere where it doesn't want to be. And freedom. Relaxation. Imagine all the muscles, sensations, everything in my waist free to be. I'm not going to tell it what to do. I'm not its master. I'm its friend. Just really slowly move out my body. Don't even take notes of what part of the body I'm on. Not fast, not slow. However long it takes to get to my stomach, even 3 hours after lunch, still feel a little bit of I don't know what to call it, but it does lead to some relaxation, some TLC. I get to know the feeling first of all. to embrace that sensation, understand it. And I give it kindness. Give it freedom to be. I'm not trying to get rid of you. Just like the monster in the Emperor's palace. You're welcome. You're part of the digestive process. Slow, fast. Hot. Cool. I feel you. This is the way my body balances itself after a meal. Just like being with something rather being against. I'm trying to go somewhere or get somewhere. So come on, stomach, you just stop this and just so I can do other things. None of that business. I have all the time in the world. Patience. Being. This feeling where I'm just still contemplating is the most important thing in the world. Now the most important time. This, the most important thing. It may not be what you expect from meditation, but it is the present moment. It is here. And I'm going to be with you. Because I care. As you find my mindfulness going up to my trachea. Giving it lots and lots of kindness. My body chooses. I just care. So it presents different parts to me. My job is to acknowledge, not with words, to know and to be kind. If there is any tightness or tension, I just expand. Sometimes a little knot of pain is like a heavy, tight ball. And I imagine it expanding and expanding and expanding. As it expands, it gets less dense. Less heavy. So I expand it. Expand, expand, till it just fills the whole universe. Because so free and light, what was once a lot of pain, is now like a vapor. So light, so free. Kindness allows things to be loose and natural and open. Not trussed up with fear, but loose with kindness. Go way up, shaking my arms. They're already tingling, they're already comfortable. My hands, they're not in the usual meditation posture you see in books. I've never seen any books saying you should put one hand in your lap and the other one around a microphone. It's fine. Even around the microphone, you can feel just the hard, smooth, slightly cold, metallic. Against my soft fingers. And go up. My throat is irritable. Have a cough. But throat, I trust you. When you want to cough, you may cough. You've been looking after just this part of my body so well. You know what to do. It's weird. When I give my throat permission to cough, it doesn't need to. When I try to stop it coughing, it really coughs. It teaches me some wisdom. Trying to control my body, or that part of my body, which makes me tight and irritable. When I'm kind, relax, letting be. Even my throat relaxes. I can feel its sensation. It's there. It's not causing any trouble. Because I'm with that feeling, rather than against it. Whatever you're experiencing, it's the most important thing in the whole world. So my meditation object right now is irritating throat feeling. That's what I'm with. Not breath, not images, but just this feeling. I'm not trying to rush it, trying to go to something different. I'm with this. Aware and mindful and kind. And many of you may experience sometimes weird stuff happening. I've got an image appearing in my throat. I'm just with things. I'm feeling powerful. And go to your face and head. You come across any tightness, tension. Just relax. Be open, kind. To the point that your whole body is relaxed as it possibly could. As it's been relaxing in a spa bath. Not too hot, not too cold. And all of the parts of your body is at ease and peace. And I feel my body as a whole, including my brain, relaxed to the max. I stay with my body because the times is really delightful. Ease, relaxation, with a delight. I get to know that delight. And the first time that I was investigating this, exploring it, when I focus, the object of my meditation was the delight of relaxation. And my body went to a deeper level of relaxation. the delight took me there. Getting to know my body. As you focus on delightful awareness, it's so easy to stay there. And the awareness grows. You become more aware. You feel and sense more things. It gives you more opportunity to relax even deeper. Sometimes you realize how tight you have been because of fear, control. Now you feel your body, you really are relaxing her more than you ever thought possible. Just being, and being kind. It's not even that you do this, you just allow it to happen. You free your body. So we can find its own optimum comfort. Once you relax the body, you can just carry on if you like. I'm tempted just to stay with my body and just let it relax more. If you want to start to relax the mind, see if you can recall in your past, this is bringing up the past, but a nice past. The time from your past when you were so happy, so content. The happiest moment of your life so far. Time when you never wanted to be anywhere else, with anybody else, at any other temperature or place. Moments of utter contentment. Sometimes the most unexpected places. Where was that? The most happy, content, free moments of your life. Build a picture. What was the weather like? Was it cold or raining or snowy or warm? How was the sky? Was it under the trees, out in the open, or in a room? How old were you? Who was with you? Maybe nobody. Where were you sitting or lying? You can notice how strange it is. It wasn't the most perfect place in the world. Because you were at peace, content, you never wanted anything else in the whole world other than to be where you were, with who was beside you. In that place. Build up the image as best you can. How long did it last? Just the most content, free, at ease, still moment of your life. What do you feel like in your body? stillness, peace. How satisfying was it for your mind? Sometimes you don't know how you got there. You were there. The peace, at ease, content. Just it's beautiful, happy. Not of stimulated senses, the peaceful senses. What did that peace feel like? See if you can recall as much as possible of the state of peace, serenity, ease. With that feeling of ease. It's as if you've transported the peace, the ease, the serenity of that most wonderful experience, which was long ago, into this moment called now. Like it echoes. It's here. Now. Ease. Peace. Just being here. Satisfied, content, at peace, not wanting anything in the whole world, because you're already here. And your object of meditation, just this peace. Serenity, comfort, being satisfied, not needing anything else in this moment, experiencing a taste of freedom.
opportunity for a 10-15 minute break.